Thank God for music. We don't owe no rights to this music, but we thank God for it. Tonight our lesson comes from Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 7. If you have your Bibles, get that ready. Sorry, I signed down, I think, a minute after having some technical difficulties, so hopefully everything comes through okay. You know, the devil always gotta try to throw something out there to distract us, but God always has a ram in the bush. Amen. So hopefully you can see me clearly, you can hear me clearly. If not, the devil won't get the victory. We'll do it all over again. Because God got it. Glory. We thank you for another hour, another impact hour, another day, another moment in time that we can learn and study together in his word. Amen. Thank you all for joining us, tuning in for our live stream Bible study. You could have been anywhere else, but you came and sat to hear a word from the Lord, and we give God glory. Let us pray. Oh, Father God, we thank you for this day, God. We thank you for all that it has entailed, God. We thank you for your hand of protection. We thank you for keeping us, God, for covering us, for shielding us from every seen and unseen danger, oh God. We thank you for the blessings that you have provided for us on this day, God. And we thank you now that we come to get a spiritual word from you, God. We pray that this is the word that we may be hide in our heart, so that we may not sin against thee, O God. Help us to be more like you, God. Here we are in a place to learn, God, to love God, so that we can be gracious about applying your word intentionally in our everyday life. God, we ask right now that you manifest your glory in the lives of your people. Give them eyes to hear, eyes to see, ears to hear, and a heart to receive what thus says the Lord. In Jesus' name I do pray. Amen and amen. Amen. As I said before, if you couldn't hear me, hopefully you can hear me now. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 7 is where we're studying from on tonight. And the topic is, where is your trust? Amen. Where is our trust? Sometimes we're trusting in horses and chariots and such things, but we should be trusting in the Lord. It's what the word tells us. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 7, little short, simple verse, and it reads, blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord and whose hope the Lord is. Doesn't seem like it's something hard for us to do, but sometimes it is. It's hard because we make it hard. Because we're human. We have carnal minds, and if we don't allow the Holy Spirit to lead, to guide, to rest in us as we abide in Christ, we don't trust in the Lord. We trust in everything and everybody but the Lord. So here we are to get this quick word from the Lord. Blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord and whose hope the Lord is. Blessed with spiritual security is the man who believes and trusts in and relies on the Lord and whose hope and confident expectation is the Lord. Confident, being assured, not wavering, because a double-minded man is unstable in all, not one, but in all of his ways. So James told us, when we trust and hope in the Lord, the word of the Lord says that, for he will be nourished like a tree planted by the waters. He being man, woman, boy, girl, he that trusts in the Lord will be nourished like a tree planted by the waters that spread out its roots by the rivers and will not fear the heat when it comes. But its leaves will be green and moist, and it will not be anxious and concerned in a year of drought, nor stop bearing fruit. This is an on-time word. This is a timely word. I'm going to just read that one more time. And this is Jeremiah 17, verse 8. It wasn't included in our topic, but this is the meat of the text. When we trust and hope in the Lord, the word of the Lord says that, for he will nourish us like a tree planted by the waters that spreads out its roots by the river and will not fear the heat when it comes. We're living in a time where it's heated right now. People are worrying about the drought that we are in the place of America. And I say we, not necessarily including myself, because I serve a God who is able. Amen. He's able. We're not in a drought. America's in a drought. God is good. And the word tells us that he shall be like a tree planted by the waters that spreads out its roots by the river and will not fear the heat when it comes. But its leaves will be green and moist and will not be anxious and concerned in a year of drought. This is a time for drought. But he who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is the Lord, he won't be concerned in a year of drought, nor will he stop bearing fruit. Whew, that's a word. We could just say class dismissed, but we're going to keep moving on. Amen. He won't be like he won't stop bearing fruit. He won't be like in a year of a drought, because why? He's planted. He's rooted. He's grounded. He's anchored in God. And he that is anchored in God will not fear the heat when it comes. Because we know that the heat is coming. The heat is on right now. The heat is anything that's put you in a place to where you can be worried, to where you can be distracted or confused, as some would say, or feeling like you're running out of time for whatever reason. That's the heat. That's the heat that he's talking about. But when you know that you know that you know that you know that the Lord is your God without a shadow of a doubt, you won't worry about the heat. You won't fear the heat. You'll be like, bring it on, heat. It's not hot enough in here. Bring it on. Bring it on. Amen. Welcome the heat and walk with your God. And it says that, and your delight is in the law of the Lord. And in your law, you meditate on day and night. And I got this from Psalms 1, verse 3, I believe. But Psalms 1. He shall be like his delight is in the law of the Lord, and he meditates on his precepts and teaching as he's declared day and night. But in that particular passage, it says, and this man shall be like a tree firmly planted and fed by streams of water. Our God is the living water, and the man who yields his fruit in his season, his leaves do not wither.
And whatever he does, he prospers and comes to maturity. That's Psalms 1 verses 2 and 3. Forgive me. I got confused on which verse that it was. But this is where we are. When we're planted, when we're rooted, when we're grounded, when we're anchored in God, when we know that blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is the Lord. We don't have any worries. The heat can't run us off. We're there. It's nothing that the enemy can bring our way to distract us from where we are in our purpose in Christ. We just keep moving because, as the song said that we were listening to, God's got it. We don't have anything to worry about. Our attitude on any given day at any given time should be, God's got it. And because God's got it, I don't have to worry. My God will supply my every need according to his riches and his glory. My God's got it. And in my God do I trust and do I hope in. This isn't just a word of the Lord. This is a word to stand on. Stand on his word. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is the Lord. Many want to shout that they're blessed, but they don't even know how it is that they're blessed, why that they're blessed. But the word has given us a scripture and a definition per se as to how it is we can say that we're blessed. I'm blessed because I trust in the Lord and I hope in the Lord. The Lord is my hope. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my strength. The Lord is my savior. The Lord is my provider. Blessed is the man. Amen. Blessed. Whose side are you on? Whose report will you believe? Where is your faith? Where is your trust? Who is your hope in? You got to know who your God is. You got to know why it is that your God is your God, so that you can receive all the blessings that the Lord has for you. And it's just some basics that we need to get clarified. Hope in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. Believe that your God is your God and he's able, that he's got it. You don't have to fear. You don't have to fret. You don't have to be anxious. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything through prayer and supplication. Let your requests be made known unto God, because he is your God. And our text simply suggests that placing trust and hope in anything other than God, which is the God that we serve, who is the one true living God, is an idol and becomes a false representation of who our God is. God is against idols. He told us in the Ten Commandments that we are to put no other God before him. God is a jealous God. And so these idols go against who we are as kingdom kids, kingdom children, God's children. And they do not and cannot ever possess that the power that God bestows. The power that God bestows, he bestows on his children. And when we serve idols, we're not operating in God's power. So we can't have God's strength. We're not operating in his power. We don't have his strength, which will put us in a place to where we will be fearful when the heat turns up, when it get a little hot. We won't be able to be like, throw me in the fire, like the Hebrew boys. They wasn't worried about how hot the fire was going to be turned up, because they knew without a shadow of a doubt that their God was able, that their God could, and they believed that he would, and that's why he did it. You got to know that you know that you know. Can't be double-minded. You got to be unwavering. And back to these idol gods. These idol gods and trying to trust and hope in them is not going to get you anywhere. You can't trust in the universe. And I'll say that on top, because I've seen and heard about that too much here lately. The universe. What is trusting in the universe? When in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. who created this universe, that the people who are not like God are serving and worshiping. God is the creator of the heaven and the earth and everything and every being in it. We don't serve the universe. We serve God. We trust God. We hope in God, not the universe. And he created man in his own image, in the image and likeness of him. He created him, male and female. God, the God that we serve. Neither can we trust in the fortune cookie. Amen. Spiritism is forbidden in the kingdom of God. And those who serve Christ, children of God, and his father's eyes truly represent the gospel, the commandments, and his kingdom. These are what we're working on to. We're working on to the Lord. We're serving the Lord with gladness and delighting in him, following his commandments, obeying the word of the Lord that's written in his gospel, because we want to be and remain a part of his kingdom. All this other spiritism is forbidden. It is not of God. So for those who think that they're operating as Christians, but they're looking to the spiritism, which can be found in serving the universe, the fortune cookies, the zodiac, the sage, the horoscopes, and the witch doctors are practicing witchcraft, those that's using divination, that is an idol god, and that is not of God. So if you are serving and operating in any form as such, you're not walking with God. Truth is the truth. You're not walking with God. And if you like to get in a place of rightness with God, throw away those idols. Repent. Cry unto God. For you did not because you knew not, but now you know and you want to do better. Amen. For the word of the Lord says that when you have entered into the land which the Lord your God is giving you, you shall not learn to imitate the detestable, repulsive practices of those nations. There shall be found among you anyone who makes his son or daughter pass through the fire as a sacrifice, one who uses divination and fortune telling, one who practices witchcraft, or one who interprets omens or sorcerers, or one who casts a charm or spell or medium or spiritist or necromancer who seeks the dead. For anyone who does these things is utterly repulsive to the Lord. And because of these detestable practices, the Lord your God is driving them out before you. The word that for you, what's for you in this is you shall be blameless and complete and perfect before the Lord your God when you don't do these things. But when you do these things and attach yourself to the things that's in the land that the Lord has, the place that the Lord has sent you to, then you're not considered blameless. You are to blame because the Lord told you not to do it. It's written in the scripture, Deuteronomy 18, 9 and 12. For these nations which you shall depossess to put out of possession or occupancy, I like to say to take over. The Lord is going to put you in a place as he has done us to take over a land. And in that land is going to be detestable things that are being practiced in that land. And so you're going to really be a foreigner because you're coming in and you're operating in the spirit of God. And those that are there don't know the one true living God, although they may think that they are. They maybe thought that they were walking with him and living in him. But when they recognize the spirit of God in you, it's going to put fear in them. And God is saying here, it is for you, for us, to not fall into these detestable practices so that we can be considered blameless, complete, perfect before the Lord our God. And then we will be like a tree planted by the rivers of the living water, which the living water is in us, is coming from amongst us. And we won't want for nothing. We won't want for nothing. We won't fear anything. All we know is what? God's got us. Hey, man, God's got us. And they are the people in those nations that the Lord has put you in a place to possess, to take it over. They are those who practice witchcraft and divination and fortune tellers and all of these little things. And while I'm speaking on this, said something about charms and mediums. There's these little things that I don't have one on, but it's little bracelets or whatever, where people are buying and the companies are making big money off of it. It's supposed to do something to your energy or help you do this to be in a better mood, or I don't know about these little things. Y'all might want to consider what it is that you're doing, what you've been practicing in, because there is no bracelet, there is no necklace, there is no greater being than our God. And if you fall into such trap of witchcraft and you wearing it on this body that is supposed to be the temple of the Lord, then you're not walking with God. No sense of being foolish when you know better. God can't bless that. He is expecting you to walk upright and not to become like the world, not to be foolish. That's why sheep need a shepherd, so that they can know better and do better. Thank God for the truth. For the truth of his word, which we are standing on. The God that we serve want us to follow in his ways. And we just starting with the basics. You know, this is a new little live stream Bible study. I just figured out, oh, well, Lord, give us a way to where we can just walk in this thing week by week from the basics. And this is just something so simple. Trusting in the Lord, hoping in the Lord, believing in God, and not serving idols, because that is a big thing. You know, there is no sin that's greater than the other. All sins are sin. If you fall short in one thing and you think you uphold in other things, it doesn't matter. You sin. But we want to get those commandments in us so that we can obey them. We're not going to obey idol gods. Maybe this is what you did last week, last year. But no, moving forward, this is the year that the Lord has set. What are we going to do for him? What are we going to do for him? Are we going to continue to do what we know is wrong and use a scripture that we've heard Apostle Paul say, when I would do good, evil was always present? You know, I knew to do right, but I wouldn't do right. That scripture has been taken out of context, so it doesn't mean that you still carry on in not doing well. God wants you to know better, to do better, and to help somebody else to come up so that they can be better. And this is the kind of ministry that should be pushed out. And this is what you'll find here at Empowerment Temple Church of God. We're honoring the Lord, the word of God, serving God, living God, loving God, and loving on God's people, loving you all the way to life, loving you all the way to life. No need to feel dead. No need to feel like nobody is there for you. We are with you. God is with you. And as long as the God that we serve is in us, you don't have to worry about a thing. God's got you. Amen. What an awesome God that we serve. Obedience is better than sacrifice. And great shall thy reward be when we serving God, when we loving God, when we're doing the things of God, when we're learning the word of God, bit by bit. You know, we're going to get from milk to meat. And we're going to know how to stay in sync with God. And some of the things that we've been serving, these idol gods, I didn't really want to talk about people today, but some of us have even put people before God. We've made people our God. Put no man before God. God is a jealous God. these things that we're doing. Some people need to really rid their house of some charms or products and a bunch of stuff that you got to really read between the lines. The lines don't even need to be there for you to read between them. You know what's an idol. You know, let me just say this. You know, if you share a post and it's inscripted at the bottom, say, Buddha. Was Buddha really a man? Can Buddha talk? I don't think so. But it's just the idea that people are spreading foolishness. You know, it could have been a word that they twisted or got from somewhere, but they signed it as Buddha. You can't share that type of message with that inscription. No, you got to know better, because that means that, oh, that was a sin for you on that day, at that moment, in that time. These are idol gods. We got to look and think more about what it is that we're doing, what we're sharing, what we're saying, what we're taking into this temple that belongs to God. We got to serve God with it. And so it's not just about the things that we're putting in us. Some people think from different cavities of the body. It doesn't matter. You're putting it on you. You're wearing it on your wrist. You're wearing it on your neck. You're wearing it on your ankle or wherever it is that you may be. You know, we've been so worried about tattoos. Who tattooed the body? Who did this or who did that? A lot of these people, including myself, when we walked away from God or we rebelled against God, yeah, we did some rebellious things. But when the Lord called us, saved us, drew us out from among them, we were marked. But you can tell the difference. Some don't have tattoos, but what they selling, it ain't godly. They may as well have them. They may as well be marked. Amen. God knows his people. And just as he forgave Paul, Saul, who was a chief sinner, he said that he would suffer much for his sake, but he was going to do great. This is why he was able to cover the Gentiles. He was the apostle of the Gentiles, and Peter was the apostle of the Jews. See, what Paul had gained in him from being in the wilderness, Peter didn't have. Peter couldn't give. God knew that Paul was going to be a different breed, and he needed that to deal with the Gentiles. Amen. Here we are, Gentiles, and I'm seeing it, and I understand so much so why we, and I'm speaking of me and my household, why we suffer so much, because the Gentiles have gotten worse than they were in Paul's day. And so we have to suffer a little bit more in the wilderness so that we can stand strong and tell the devil he is a liar and the truth ain't in it. And that's just how real it gets. So we on Paul's side. He's the apostle of the Gentiles, and God gave him an even greater strength, a greater anointing, a greater power, and let the people know that this is who I chose for to lead my people in the way of the Lord. And here we are in the strength of God, speaking the word of God in such a time as this to help draw God's people in and to stop participating in the things that do not please God, so they won't continue to walk around self-righteous and calling somebody else a sinner when no man is perfect. We're all sinners. But we don't all practice sin. And so we just highlighted something tonight that is very much sin. If you look into Sage, if you look into the fortune teller, the horoscope, the zodiac, the universe, you're in great sin. And you need to repent, because God loves you. God cares for you. And he wants you to come back to him. It's not about pleasing the people. God needs you to please him so that the blessings of God can flow in your life. Amen. We give God glory. What an awesome God that we serve. And we thank you all for joining in and tuning in with us this evening. Yeah, we can get a little pumped up at times. It might take us a little minute. We don't come out like a horse out the stable, but oh yeah, we can get excited about the things of God because God has been so, so, so good to us. Amen. Whew, thank you, Jesus. I'm in another place right now. I'm fired up. I'm really fired up. God is good. God is faithful. God is kind. God is my everything. And we ask that you all continue to join in with us on Tuesday evenings at 7 o'clock. If it's the Lord's will, we'll meet back here next week, 7 p.m., for another great Bible study, another great word of the Lord, so that we can earnestly walk with Him. Where is your trust? Trust in God, not man, not idols. Keep your trust in God. That is where your trust should be. We give God glory. We thank God for our pastor who is watching up with us online. And Pastor, we love you. Thank you for allowing us to speak on behalf of the Lord, to give unto the work of the Lord through this ministry. You all may do so now via Cash App. Our Cash App is $ETEMPLECOG. That's Cash App. If you like to give via Zelle, our Zelle's address is etemple.inc@disciples.com. And if you have Givelify, you may find us through Givelify at Empowerment Temple Church of God. And those of you who like to continue to tribute by mail, you may do so by making your check of money order out to Empowerment Temple Church, P.O. Box 1488, White House, Texas 75791. God bless you all real good. We hope that you would tune in next week to continue to grow in the grace of God. Go in peace. Peace be unto you.